And welcome back. And today I'm going to take a little look at bead software design tools. And if you're anything like me, you will have started your beadwork following other people's patterns. And at some point you gain enough confidence to want to design your own patterns. So I started off very much the hard way. I didn't want to spend any money. So I tried to see if my designs would be okay or good enough. So I thought I'd just use pen and paper first of all. So I drew up lots and lots of grid lines actually, and laboriously filled this in with coloured pencils to make the designs. But that took a long time. So my next stage of improvement was I would use an Excel spreadsheet and put the lines in, print that out, but then still colour this in with a pencil. But incredibly laborious still. My next level of improvement was an Excel spreadsheet, but this time I filled in the squares with colours, and this is part of my reptile skin series, which was sometime last year. So I've kept them as a sort of unique record of progress in some strange way. Anyway, so this was, of course, taking a lot of time. So I decided to take a little look around online to see what software tools are out there. You can spend an awful lot of money and you can spend zero money. There's quite a few software tools out there for design with beads that are free. However, I have a little constraint here, which is I use an Apple Mac, and most of the software tools are designed within Windows, Microsoft Windows operating system. And so you have to use an additional utility such as Bootcamp to actually make that kind of interface work. And well, I couldn't be bothered with that additional steps in there. So I was really looking for something that could work on Windows and on a Mac. So the one that I came up with was BeadTool. Now, it's not free, but it's a whole lot cheaper than some others that are out there. And I find it very good value for money because it does what it says. And I'm going to take you through it a little bit. So first of all, we have its website. So I've got the website here. It's beadtool.net. And it tells you that it's a beading software for everyone, for the hobbyist and for the professional designer. It covers a whole range of stitches from loom and square stitch, brick stitch, peyote. It has drawing tools on there, and it has a large assortment of colours of different types of beads. So whether it's Delicas or Tohos, you've got a whole range there. And one of the key things that I was very keen on was to be able to import either a photograph or a design that I had just drawn out on a piece of paper and just import that into the tool, and it could automatically translate that into a bead pattern using the closest related coloured beads. So that was a few key things. There's a whole range of compatibility. It runs on Windows and Mac computers, I've said that, but I guess it's not obvious, but it doesn't work on iPads and mobiles. I don't know if any others do, to be honest. You get free upgrades within this particular version of BeadTool, BeadTool4. So I've just upgraded it just today, actually. And there's a really useful tab on there which says learn, and there's a range of videos that tell you how to use it. So really go and look at that. What I intend to do is two videos. The first one, I'm just going to give you an overview just to see if you like it, so you see how good it is and if it works for you. And the second video, which is going to be follow-on, is actually getting into the back end of this, because it's quite sophisticated and there's some things that a lot of people might not realize you can do with this tool. And I'm hoping that you'll find it really interesting, particularly for large pieces of work that need to be scaled right, etc. So there are some secrets within this tool, So I'll hopefully be able to reveal that next time. Okay, so let's take a look at the tool itself. Okay, so here is one that I have made a little bit earlier, and you see it's all about Christmas. If we first of all look at the right hand side, there is a panel, and here where it says pattern, it's all about the stitch. So I'm just going to let that linger there, and you can choose a whole range of stitches to show on screen and work with. Square, loom, brick, peyote, all the way down to raw. Okay. Then we have the palette, and that's all about the different palettes that you can get with the different types of beads. And you can also customize a palette for a particular picture that you're doing. So that's really, really handy. So I'm just going to go back to here. What you have down the left-hand side is a selection of shapes that you can add. There's a flood fill. There's a color picker. There's a selection tool. There's an eraser and a pencil. So I'm just going to show you a little bit with the pencil. So I'm just going to go over to the pattern. So I have my selection of beads that I want to use, and I want to use yellow. I click on yellow, and then I'm just going to click and drag and put some yellow in here. And oops, I don't like that, so I'm going to now click undo. It's very, very simple. And I can do them individually if I want, like that. If I make a mistake, I can also erase using the eraser individually, either clicking them or just click and drag. It's very, very simple. What's really useful, I think, is this, which is a selection tool, and click and drag around something that you want to repeat. So if you want a repeating pattern, click and drag around it. Then select your copy. If you're using a Mac, it's easy, it's Command C. And then if you do Command V for paste, and you've got a second one, and you put it down there, and you put paste, click paste again, and there you have it. Very, very simple, very, very straightforward. Now, you also have the ability to preview the output from this, because there's no use having this all on screen if you can't preview what you're going to get out. So if I preview my print, I have a whole selection of layouts. So you can see the whole layout there. And for this one, it's the full printout. And what that means is, if I just go back to here, I've got the print of the image, I've got the number of beads that are actually needed in each for the whole thing here. And then down this way, I can go through the different pages. This is line by line, row by row, all the beads in the order in which they appear across that row. And if you're doing a big piece of work, that's really, really handy, because you don't have to count each of these beads in your pattern. It's already done for you, and that is such a help. And of course, knowing the bead count, it makes life so much easier than when I was using a pen and paper. So that's what you can output, and you can choose a number of layouts. So just the bead pattern will give you just the bead pattern. Okay. There's one more thing which I'll show you in just a moment. So I have opened up a new file in BeadTool. It's completely blank. But what I want to do is to import a picture. And this is almost a picture at random, but it's of a design I've actually made in the past. And you can see it's imported the picture, which is just behind the grid. And I'm not going to finesse about this, but all we can do is bring this out, stretch it out. And what we can do, I'll just show you this very, very briefly, is that when you click on transfer, which is up here, you have a little selection of things, so you can choose your seeds, beads or whatever, the range of colors that you want. I want nearest color. And I'm just going to press begin. And hey presto, it's created this pattern for me. Now, there may be a few little elements that aren't quite right because there's been a glint of, you know, light against the beads, but it gives me a whole bead list down there. And what I can do is actually begin to pick out some of these beads and just correct it if I want. So I can begin to correct it and make it how I want. And I actually quite like this grey and this black line going along. And that's really quite interesting, I think. So that was one of the critical things that I was really, really interested in. And I maybe forgot to say, here's the zoom, zoom in and zoom out again. So then I can just save this as a new file. And hey presto, it is as straightforward as that. So hopefully that's been quite helpful quick review of BeadTool4. I'm going to do a second video on BeadTool4, which is going to go much more into the detail. But in the meantime, just as a freebie, if you go onto Facebook or Twitter or Instagram, I've put this little picture up so that you can just go in there and download the actual image if you want. It seemed to be the simplest way of letting you have a little sample. And what I have here is a range of Christmas trees and also penguins. Now, they are my own design, but I do think the penguins look a little bit sinister, I've got to admit. But you can have a go and see what you think. But the thing that really works well is the little robin, and he's just as cute as anything. And what you need to do is also just put a little loop of beads, say 20 beads, so that you're able to hang them on a little hook on your little Christmas tree. They are small, so feel free to double them up, make them bigger. It is using square stitch, Delica's size 11s, but you can see all the details on my Facebook, Instagram and Twitter. And so have a good time, and I hope you enjoy this little bit of beading, and do come back to watch a whole lot more detail behind this on BeadTool. See you next time, same time, same place.